Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business class form 1. The topic it is the introduction to business studies. Lesson 1, I'm your tutor, Rusim Modoni. Welcome. Let us look at today's lesson goals. Today we'll be doing the definition of the term business. We also look at the business studies. We also look at what are the goods and services, and also differentiate between goods and services. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to define the term business, also should be able to define what is business studies, and also define and give the characteristics of goods and services, and also be able to differentiate between goods and services. We start by looking at the definitions, and we start with the first one, that is business. Business refers to any activity that is carried out by an individual or an organization involving provision of goods and services with the aim of making profit. So all those business activities that are started in order for you to make profit from them, that is business. But a situation where you start doing activities that are going to benefit yourself, not for commercial purposes, not to earn the profit, those are not business. So business, it is any activity that is done, any service, goods and services that are produced in order to make profit. Now we go to business studies. When we talk about business studies, is the study of the activities that are carried out in production, distribution, consumption of goods and services. So all those activities that we are going to make study, how goods are being produced, how they are being distributed, how they are being for the consumption, that is what is business studies. So business studies deals with the production or the ends of trade, that is anything that is involved in the distribution and also the consumption of that goods. Because if at all you produce a service and it is not consumed, then it is not, it does not make any profit. So business studies, that is what it is. Study of all those activities that read out to the production, distribution and consumption of goods and services. We go now to goods and services. Now, when we talk about goods, these are tangible items with monetary value. Examples, we have the cars, you have the utensils, books, laptops. Even we have all the food materials that you can be able to touch. All those ones are the goods. But when we talk about the services, are intangible activities or actions that are carried out. And all these ones are aimed to trade. They assist in trade, starting with banking, advertising, warehousing, insurance, transportation and communication, even that involve other activities like hairdressing, making of dresses, all that it is services that are offered. Even the nursing, all those ones are services. Let us look at the differences between goods and services. Goods are tangible, while services are intangible. Already that one we have seen. Some goods can be stored, while services cannot be stored. For example, I can store a car for future use, but I cannot store the service of teaching, the service of banking, in order for me to use it tomorrow. Then we go to the third one, where now we have the ownership on goods can change. Why service cannot be separated from the service provider? You cannot change the nursing. You cannot take nursing whereas you have not done that service. You cannot provide a service like someone else who is providing if at all you have not done it. Then we also have, goods can be standardized, while services cannot be standardized. Number 5, not all goods are perishable, while all services are irreperishable. Number 6, goods are visible. You can be able to see them. But when we talk about services, you cannot be able to see them. Number 7, some goods change in value over time, while services cannot change in value since cannot be stored. They cannot be stored. Now let us look at the production. Production refers to the process of creating new goods or modifying the existing ones and making them useful. So that's what it means. For example, when a farmer is producing crops, you are doing the activity, you are planting a seed and harvesting. Then we go to the distribution. Distribution refers to the movement of goods and services from the producer to consumer. All those activities that include the storing in the warehouse, transporting, insurance, communication, that is on the line of distribution. Then we go to the consumption. Consumption refers to the usage of good or services. The person who uses that good and service is referred to as consumer. For example, when we take of brushing of the teeth using the toothpaste, the person who is doing the brushing, you are using the toothpaste, you are consuming it. Other disciplines that are studying in business studies, we are going to look at them in our next lesson. We have the economics, commerce, accounting, office practices, and entrepreneurship. So we are going to look at that in our next lesson. Today's assignment, identify 4 goods essentials in library, identify business activities carried out in our day-to-day life. Then reference, you can refer from the KFB 2011 Inverter Secondary Business Student Book 1, then the edition. If at all you want to get us, if at all you want to contact us, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook and the Twitter. Stay tuned to Erim TV. Thank you.